this lesson, you're going to learn something about our TRS result view. This result view can visualize 3D data which was acquired with one of our time-resolved spectroscopy measurement functions. I will show it on an example file, which I have measured with RapidScan. It was an UV curable resin. I will open it and tap on New TRS View. Now the file is loaded, and you can see this view is divided in 4 different tiles. In the upper left corner, you can see a 3D plot, which shows time-dependent information of our spectra. On the upper right corner, you can see 2D spectra, which represent in this case the 2D spectra at the position of the blue and the red marker, which you can see on the lower left corner. The blue and the red marker in the lower left corner represent the 2D spectra at a certain time value. And the information in this window, so the green and the magenta colored lines here, these are the traces. So these are the information on how the band changes over time. So we set the pink colored marker and the green colored marker, which are shown in the upper right corner, to a specific wave number. And then the so-called trace is calculated and shows if the band intensity is changing over time. This is what we see on the lower left corner. On the lower right corner, we can see an overview of the traces which we have set. So for example, the upper list shows the position of the green and the pink colored marker. So the green one is at 1080 wave numbers and the pink one is currently at 1690 wave numbers. And the lower list, which is called spectra, shows the specific time value where we have set the blue and the red colored marker. Now we can arrange all these markers. So for example, if I tap on the green one, I can move it around here and set it, for example, at a position of approximately 806 wave numbers. And the pink marker, I will move to a band at approximately 1240 wave numbers. As you now can see in the lower left corner, the bands with the pink marker are increasing in intensity over time, and the band which I have located the green marker on it is decreasing over time. And if we now move the red marker to the right position and the blue marker, say, to the left position, and then focus on the 2 spectra which are shown on the upper right corner, we can see that the difference in the intensity is significant. So for the position of the green marker, the red colored spectrum or the red colored band shows a lower intensity as at the beginning of this measurement, where the blue colored marker is set on. There is the intensity much higher. And for the pink colored marker, it's vice versa. It's also possible to expand one of these 4 views. So for example, the 3D view can be expanded. Now we can move this 3D view around to get the perfect angle to visualize one of my data. I can use a 1-finger gesture to move and tilt and turn it, or I can use 2 fingers to zoom in and zoom out. The same can be done on the upper right corner with the 2D spectra. We can zoom in and zoom out or move it around. If we want to visualize additional spectra in our 2D view on the upper right corner, we can open the spectra list, which is located on the left side of this view. With a click on spectra list, we open it. This spectra list contains all individual spectra which are measured in this case. And these individual 2D spectra are then stitched together to the 3D view, which we could see prior. Now we can move around this list and activate specific values. So for example, I'm interested in the spectra which was measured at 8.72 seconds. I can activate it via the slider, and it's automatically been added in the view at the upper right corner. And also on the lower right corner, you can see there's an entry added in the spectra list. Then I can add additional spectra if I want to, or deselect them. And if I have individualized everything, I can close the spectra list again to get back to my full view. And as you can see, you have a bunch of possibilities to visualize and proceed your data here. I hope you could learn something about this 3D view. Watch also one of our other videos.